murder suicide in Rio Rancho. Action 7 News reporter Justin Matthews shows us how shops are giving back to raise money for funeral costs.
A pretty incredible display of support here in Riverside Plaza. The line from the Pulitzer Bar stretching all the way to the far corner here. Between 6 and 8 o'clock, every single thing you buy at the Pulitzer Bar and the neighboring business, Spring Rollin', goes directly to the victim's family. One of the owners of the businesses, Deepo Alam, says he used to coach Adrian Velasquez in soccer. He's the younger brother who was killed Christmas Day. Alam says he'll never forget Adrian's energy and passion for the sport.
Can you teach me how to kick? Can you teach me how to do this? And he just won more, even though he felt he won more. And that's the one that I always kind of like, I remember one thing I told him, like, you know, every setback set up for a greater comeback. And
tonight will be donated to them to help with funeral costs.
Hello, sir. How are you today?
I also spoke to one of the family's neighbors, Brittaney Peacock-Hill.
You can just feel like this darkness, like this shadow, is just lingering because of something so tragic like that that can happen. It's just numb and quiet.
Over the years, she says she's had many neighborly waves and smiles with the family.
I don't know them personally, but from what I've gathered from my family, working with them and friends, Marilyn was a very wonderful woman, person, colleague. I would say the kids were really smart. I mean, Roberta was at Stanford. Adrian, he was 14, freshman in high school. That's young, but he was very involved. And the dad, he served our country. You know, even though something so tragic happened the way it did, he did serve our country. He is a veteran, and we can't shadow that.
If you want to pay your respects to the family, you still can. There's going to be a candlelight vigil at King Meadows Park in Rio Rancho next Sunday, January 5th at 5:30 p.m. Reporting in Albuquerque, Justin Matthews, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Family members told us tonight the older brother, Roberto, had just completed his first semester studying engineering at Stanford University.